Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to show you how to create your own custom formula inside of VBA and use it inside of your Microsoft Excel spreadsheet.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
I would like to start this lesson a little differently this week. So today I am on our blog. And here is the link to our blog up here in the address bar, and I will also include this link in the description of the video below. But if I'm to scroll down to step number 3, where it says download this file and copy and paste the code into the module section, I would like to start by having you click on that link, and you will see a page of various functions that we use in this lesson on our blog. But for today, I'm just going to use this first function. And the function begins with the word public up here, and it ends with the phrase end function right down here. And the name of this function is match patterns using regex. So I'm going to highlight from the public down to the end function and right click and go to copy. And then I'm going to alt tab to Excel. And in my Excel spreadsheet, what I have here is a list of email addresses. And what I would like to do is use the function that I created to see if this email address ends in @gmail.com or not. But before I can call my custom function, I need to take what I just pasted on the clipboard and put it into VBA. So in order to access my VBA window, I'm going to hit Alt F11. But if you have a newer keyboard, you might need to use Alt Function F11. And that will bring up the VBA window. Once you're in the VBA window, you can right click over here and go to Insert and go to Module. And I can see over here that a folder called Modules and Module 1 has been inserted automatically by VBA. But I'm just going to right click here and paste the code that I had copied from our blog into the VBA window. And that's it. I don't need to write any more code. I can just reuse the code that we've put on our blog for you. But right up here, the most important thing is to remember the name of this function is match pattern using regex. And you will see a few inputs. First, we need a range, which is one or more cells in Excel. And then we need a pattern. And then there's an optional argument over here for matching the case. So when you're done pasting the function in here, just go up to this top X here and click it, and you will be returned to the Excel window.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So now, when I click on cell B2, if I type equals match, I can see my new function right here that I just pasted in VBA. So if I double click on that, it's automatically been loaded into the bar up here. So if I click right after the parenthesis, and the first argument that I want to use in here is my range of cells that have my email address. So I'm going to highlight here and drag down to the end of my email addresses. So that's my first argument. Which range am I evaluating? And then I'm going to type a comma. And now I'm going to type what string of text I want to find in that range. So I'm going to start with a double quote because my entire string needs to be in double quotes. And I'm going to use this string that's going to encompass all capitalized letters. So I'm going to type a capital A, a dash, a capital Z. And then I'm going to type a lowercase a, a dash, a lowercase z to get all of the lowercase letters. And then I'm going to type 0-9 to get all of my numbers. And then let's look over here in my column of email addresses. What other kinds of characters do I have besides letters and numbers? Well, I can see an underscore and a single apostrophe. So let's do an apostrophe and an underscore. And that looks like it for now. So I'm going to take that entire block of characters and I'm going to click before the A and I'm going to enclose that whole block of characters in square brackets. And then I'm going to type a plus and then what I want to find, which is at gmail.com. And then I'm going to close my quotes and close my parentheses and hit enter. And I can see that the match pattern using regex has been copied to all of my cells below here because this is a table. And I can see that the evaluation is actually calculating correctly. These first two are Gmail accounts. This next one is not. This next one is. These next two are not. So I am returned with a true when I do have at gmail.com and a false when I do not. On our blog, we have also given you a replace and an extract function as well. And using those functions will be very similar to what we just did here. So go ahead and try those out and see if those functions work for you. So hopefully that gives you an idea of how you can take a VBA function and you can use it inside of Microsoft Excel for doing almost whatever you want to do if you're able to write the VBA code. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.